stars are Tharu tribals and the Rhino Rehabilitation Project. After breakfast, we are off on a long drive across the core forest to the northernmost edge of Dudhwa Tiger Reserve. To reach the Indo-Nepal frontier, demarcated by River Mohana, we have to walk past a gaucher or grazing ground. We are likely to see several now virtually extinct Himalayan griffon vultures soaring in the sky. Trudging further ahead, we pass by a patch of Shisham forest, which is home to numerous multicolored butterflies. Finally, having reached Mohana, you can wade through the crystal clear water to enter Nepal. You can try to catch fish using Tharu techniques. Here, on a far-off border area where all you can see are hutments and security outposts, when you are really exhausted and famished, we have a special meal arranged for you in the Tharu village of Masan Kham. Tharus are an ethnic forest-dwelling community who live in Indo-Nepal Terai region. They have their own distinct lifestyle, dialect, heritage, traditions, crafts, songs, dances and costumes. As such, you haven't really explored Dudhwa if you have missed visiting Tharu villages. Post lunch, we drive down to Dudhwa range for the jeep safari. Dense sal canopies can be seen in this range. It is so dense at some places that even sunlight does not reach the forest floor. You also crisscross the vast grassland at Sonaripur range, where atop the watchtower at Banketal, you have a perfect vantage point to observe water birds, wild boars, swamp deer, elephants, and occasionally a python sunning itself. As we move on the edge of River Suheli, our jungle journey becomes a roller coaster ride. The riverine forest consists of creepers, climbers, fig trees. They appear like ghostly maze. Apart from tigers, sloth bear too inhabit this place. Crocodiles can be seen basking on the riverbank, especially during winters. Further ahead, we move parallel to the electrically fenced rhino rehabilitation area. Rhinos, extinct in Dudhwa for almost a century, were relocated here from Nepal and Assam in 1980s. They have a viable number now and are a star attraction of Dudhwa. If luck is in favor, we might see a huge armored rhino munching leaves and grass near the fence itself. This is one of the most successful conservation projects in the world.